Hello everyone, welcome to Fundo Tester. In this session we are going to discuss how to automate post API or how to automate post request. So in previous session we have discussed how to automate get request and how to create a project for REST API automation. For previous video you can go through Fundo Tester and you can find a playlist of REST API automation. So here we are going to use TESTNg to run our test and we are writing a method for post API automation. So in this we need to import TESTNg and first we are going to set our base URI. So REST assured dot base URI is equal to, we need to give our base URI. So we have here post request, so I'm going to use this. This is my base URI, so I'm going to use here and we need to write REST assured dot given dot body. So here we need to pass body here. So how can we pass the body? So if I go here, I can see for post request I can see here this is my body. So what I am going to do, I am going to copy entire body and I am going to pass here and name I am giving Fundo Testers and job SDET. Okay, this is my body. We are writing post request, so we need to write post dot then. So after then what we are going to assert, that we need to write after then. So we are writing dot then dot log. We are going to log our entire response and along with the headers. So we need to write log all and we are asserting our status code. So we need to write assert that dot status code. So status code accept int value. So we need to pass appropriate int value. We are going to get 201 response. So we need to pass our response here and we can hit. So if we are going to hit this request using TESTNg, we can see here. So our test is pass, failure is 0 and skip is 0. And we have created one resource which has ID is 96. And we can see here created time is today's date and current time. We can see headers also here. Now there are one more way. We can define a string response. We can pass reference variable for that. So simply we can use here. And instead of passing entire body here, we can simply pass JSON. So this way also we can hit our post request. So if I going to hit this, I can get the similar response. Yes, we are getting similar response. Now here challenge comes when we are working with the dynamic body. So for each and every request body will not be same. So we cannot pass body as a string in real time scenario. So what we are going to do in further session, we are going to use JSON object and we are creating dynamic body. So how real time scenario works, as we have seen in get request. So in get request we are generally passing two things, one is params and another is headers. Similar way in post request also we are passing two things, one is headers and one is body. Header cannot be a that much dynamic, but body will be a dynamic. So for each and every request body will change, even key will remain same, but value will be changed. So we will learn how we can dynamically use our request body. For further session please subscribe Fundo Tester. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching the video.